These cliff dwellings were built in shallow caves and under rock overhangs in canyons. They leveled the ground, sometimes dug the rock to enlarge the surface for their dwelling, and used the space to build a village inside the cliff. Stones were shaped and walls were made thick enough to support multiple stories. Circulation in these villages was as much vertical as it was horizontal. The entrance door to houses was generally on the second floor, and there were ventilation holes with ladders to go up or down inside the houses. The floors were made of wood, and the insides were often decorated with petroglyphs, that is to say, signs carved in stone, or paintings. Like villages in the open, cliff dwellings had a public space, a plaza, in front of the houses, where women would grind corn, men would make tools, or children would play. Mesa Verde is the largest of these dwellings, and its main building material is sandstone. It is believed it had a population of about 100 people, living in 150 rooms. But beyond its modest population, it is also believed that it was at the center of a larger community that included smaller villages all around. That would have made it a small social and political center. One question raised by these cliff dwellings is why the trouble of building such structures when the majority of ancestral Puebloans lived in regular villages. It could have been for protection against intruders, because in the 13th century, climatic conditions may have worsened in the region and reduced food production, leading to conflicts. Villages were probably very vulnerable to attacks. They could be attacked from any side, whereas cliff dwellings were much harder to invade, and they gave a sense of security, maybe. The occupation of Mesa Verde for approximately 70 years in the 13th century has been indicated by tree ring dating of the wood they used in the construction.